Good day. Today's class, last two classes, I have already covered basics of Python. Continuation in the last class, we are basically discussing Python. But anyway, there is always a comparison come with the C language, because C language you will have to cover this semester. I already covered that the data structure is the main point. It depends on the algorithm. Then you might ask which one comes first, whether it's a data structure first or algorithm. My opinion and computer scientist's opinion, algorithm is the first point. What type of algorithm we choose? We have discussed the brute force algorithm like selection sort. Then we have discussed little about the divide and conquer, that is the MART sort. We divide these things and divide and divide, then we'll get some advantage. Then others are other type of random algorithm is there, dynamic programming divide and dynamic programming algorithm is there. But all type of algorithm requires a data structure, so that where you hold your data, because your data can be integer, it can be floating point number, it can be date, it can be set. So where you can put a data, if you put some intelligent structure, then your program length is less, there will be less chance of error. That is the main thing. The C language, whenever it was designed in 1961-62 at Bell Labs, Dennis Ritchie, the famous computer scientist at Carnegie, at that time computer is very precious, and so computer resources are very precious. The memory maybe only 8K, like this. So they always very very concerned about the memory. You should not use much more, so more focused about the memory. But whenever now time we have a memory is very cheap, we have a multiple cores in a CPU, then memory is not so concerned. So whenever you are in Python, you would see whenever you are creating an integer or when it is string, a new variable is there. We never touch that variable content, so we are creating as if another variable, and we put the values there. So it is a immutable sort of thing. You basically are changing it, but you are creating another copy. Say in a string, if we string one, we have done say ABC, then we say put string one again ABCD, then it is a basically damn new string. So it is not go there and add D there. We'll come to that. It is immutable. So in C, the integer is there, floating point number is there, character is there. In Python, you see, we don't have a character, we have only a string. It contains a number of characters. And integer, in C, there's various kinds of integer. 8-bit integer, unsigned integer, signed integer, 16-bit, 32-bit, 64-bit, long, double. But in Python, it's very simple, it's one kind of integer. And it can have any size. That is a great thing. Even Java doesn't have it. So there's a Python is only one type. Float also in C, various kinds of float. Character is not there. That is in Python, that is in place by a string, it is immutable. Pointer, whole concept is not there. It is very risky thing. It actually give reference the actual content into your primary memory. It is not there. And these user defined data structure are built in the Python, most of it, not all. Well, I'll go to it. Next slide, you will see it here. Same thing, data types. I have told you character is not that, it is in Python, it is a string, floating integer. See all kinds of integers in C. That is the time, every time you have to run the program, C program, to a different computer, you have to compile it again. But you know the Python program, it can run in everywhere. So there is one kind of, that is great also in Java also. We always compare between C, Python and Java. But you must remember Python came earlier than Java, and Java has very peak time from 97 to till now, but Python is peaking lately. So Python is developed 1991 and Java in 92. Yes. So we'll come to this. This is the C. I have told you the C. This is the various kinds of formats, C language. That is something you have to remember again and again, but that is not there in Python. Yeah, Python, it is a Python, this is the code data type. This is great. The number is, as I have told you, integer, and there is another type, a Boolean type, true or false, floating point. And another great thing is complex. I have covered in my last class, like 2 plus 3j, that is a complex number with 2 plus 3j. 3j is a imaginary part. And there is another great thing is the sequence. Sequence and set. What is the difference between sequence? Sequence is there is a indexing like 0, 1, 2. The strings is there, string. And this string and another is tuple. I'll come another is list. List is mutable, you can add certain item to it, but in tuple you cannot. I'll go to difference, what is difference between list and tuple. List you can have integer, floating point number, string in the context, but it's a mutable, it is changeable. In C language everything is mutable, because I have told you memory is very precious there. We cannot throw a memory like this, but now we found it whenever the program runs, it is faster if we have immutable and mutable, like which doesn't change much, like my first name, Shomnath, or last name, Raichodi. It doesn't change in the program according. So better we put it in a sign pen which is cannot change, a string. String is immutable. So list, say we have a number of students in your class, I can put, say if you are in a second year or third year, so I can post in a list also and in tuple. So we'll discuss when to go for list, when to go for tuple, whenever always there is number of students change, so there is better put in a list, but certain things we can put it in tuple, like your say college roll number and university roll number, I can put in a tuple. This doesn't change like this much. So then I'll come to this. So this is immutable data types, it is not there in C. It is give faster performance because we have a plenty of memory, tuples there, and this is mutable. List is mutable. List is kind of a C array. The difference of array and list that I covered in the class, this array, the same type of content should be there, list it doesn't need. And another great thing is dictionary. Dictionary is a basically left hand side is a index and right hand side is a value. Left hand side should be a immutable. I'll come and set is a kind of collection. I'll come to what is the difference between collection and sequence. Sequence, set doesn't have any sequence. Set, I know, is a mathematical set. It cannot have any sequence, it's a collection, but it should be unique. So again, come to this, there's a code data type. All these things are missing in the C. C here is a character, and is array of characters taken as a string with a backslash 0, that is a null character in C. But Python, basic character type is not there, all a string, and is immutable. You cannot change. Yes. Data type, I'll give us another example like data type here. You can see I have told you sequence. Sequence, like it can have a string, it can have a tuple. You can have index it, and a certain and mapping is kind of collection like directionary and set. You cannot index it. Index, you cannot do it here. Yeah, this is an example like Python variable. Say whenever you don't have to say integer x. Whenever this is a variable name, and this is a content. After getting the content, variable type is defined. So whenever you give the 45, it will automatically take an integer. Whenever you say a string, remember in Python you can string in double quote or single quote. My preference is go for double quote, no confusion. But you cannot start with a double quote and end with in single quote. So it should be either double quote or single quote. My preference is double quote. So whenever you put a string into it, automatically take the value. And this is the indication for list. How to detect the list? This is third bracket opening, third bracket end, and it can be separated by commas. The values, this is the integer, the floating point number, and it is a mutable. Whenever you see, you can add to list, there are some functions or additional 46 functions are there. You can have many operations on list. This is a list, and this is string hello. This is one string hello. Then I change it. String 2 is equal to string 1 plus Python. The separately new string. It doesn't go to Python. Is added here. So this is a string 1, and this is string 2. That is the thing. It is called immutable. That is mean I cannot change it on a string. I create another thing. That is a much faster operation. We will see it. This is the difference between the tuples and list I have covered. That tuples is the first bracket opening and end. You don't have to write a tuple there. You just, if you give the items with the first bracket opening and first bracket ending with comma, that is tuples. And when to is tuple, when to is list, I will tell again. Tuple, generally, whenever you have a collection of items around 10 or 11, which doesn't change, tuple is much faster. Whenever you are putting in a for loop, you want to, that you can put it that is a tuple, a for loop. This is all is much faster. Tuple takes smaller spaces memory and it is a faster. But whenever the tuples, you cannot add and delete any item, but there can be duplicate items in tuple, that is possible. This is list items are surrounded by the third bracket opening and beginning. I told you tuples are immutable, list are mutable. There's a number of methods, list methods are more definitely. And in dictionary, I have told you the left hand side should be index. It can be any immutable things. It can be integer, it can be a tuple. It cannot left dictionary. In dictionary, left hand side cannot be a list. It should be immutable one. Right hand side can be a list. We'll discuss about this. Yeah, this is the Python different list, tuple, dictionary in another way. List, I told you it's a third bracket opening and beginning. Like example, this is a string. This string here they use a single quote. Anyway, it can be done with double quote or single quote. Okay, no issue, but you don't mix up. List is mutable. Tuple is always like this. Like you cannot add in this thing. Tuple is immutable and this is a faster. Dictionary is unordered. It is basically a collection. It is unordered. Within the collection, the sequence is also there, but sequences, examples I told you, list, tuple. This is an example of the sequence. You can have index with 0, 1, but dictionary cannot have an index. Dictionary is unordered. It is a changeable and index like this. Dictionary, second bracket opening, this is the name. This is a, because the string that is immutable. And right hand side also string. This is also immutable. Right hand side can be mutable and immutable. The left hand side should be immutable. And these are the pairs. These are the pairs. Like name is, this is the dictionary. And you have to search can by index. And set is the immutable collection. Set is another unordered. And this thing. Like in all our mathematical operation, you see in computer science, you have lots of using the set. So these are all the features that are available in Python. So you can program, length is much shorter, and these are built in support. Yeah, more distinction with about the list and tuple. List is mutable, I told. Implication of iteration time consuming. List is it because it takes more much greater space in memory because of its flexibility. It can be added, so it takes time consuming. Whenever it is a tuple faster, list is better in performance and insertion deletion. If you have a user, definitely list is better, tuple you cannot. Same thing, this has several built-in methods, tuple definitely because tuple is less functional, but it has performance is oriented. List is definitely can give some errors, exception in generally in all this program we call exception instead of error. Just a revision of this, list is mutable, that you can add and delete an item. It's ordered, definitely you have on that 0, 1 and on. Another is list is you can get it a minus 1 so that you can get it from reverse side also. We'll show it example, index and slicing so that you can always take a chunk of it. Duplicate items can be there. In tuple, it can be not mutable, all the features are there. So definitely less number of functions will be there because it's not mutable. Set is unordered. So that is the thing, indexing, slicing cannot be done, duplicate items cannot be there, it's set. So these are all the features of the collection. So it give you much better performance. Yeah, set can be declared by better is with this keyword set, like I say set b e, like this all these consonant is there, b no alphabets are there. I can have a mix of this, like the set is an unordered collection of objects. Like it's a kind of unlike sequence. Sequence is I told you is indexing is there. Sets cannot have duplicate numbers. All members are hashable. We'll come to this. What is hashable? So that you can directly get to it, just like dictionary. Yeah. There's an example of set. I'll give you a practical example. You can how to declare a set and all this. Set to a special syntactic form. The set you cannot detect generally by these keys. It is generally used for both in set and dictionary. Better we use the set command. Like here we are using set command. Like I am declaring a set. Like B is a set of 1 and 2. So that is a better way. The set is a keyword. Python dictionary is like this. This is a PyDict, and how I can know it is dictionary because the second bracket opening and second bracket ends, and in the items are separated by commas, and these are key values. This is separated by colon. This is key. This is the value. Key value pairs. This is a key value pair. This is how can I know it? This is a second bracket opening segment. This is a Python dictionary. Another thing I'll come to this the typing. Strong, static and dynamic. I have covered in my last class that C language is a static variable declaration. Whenever a variable you declare it integer, all along the life cycle of the program it will be always integer. Same as the Java, it is a static, but in Python that is a dynamic. Like this is static, and Python it is a dynamic. But it is a dynamic, but it is very strong. So once a variable is integer, you cannot combine with string, okay, with the plus operator that I covered in last class. That is this, it is a strong type. So it is a, though it is dynamic, but whole decision whether you go for the static typing, because static typing gives you lot of error correction. You can check lot of things in before compilation time, and a dynamic time in a Python is that whenever it's a dynamic typing, error or exception came at runtime, there's some definitely disadvantage and it will be definitely slower, but there is some strong reason for it. It is a more kind of open, it's a more kind of a language which works out at the back end and everywhere. So there is it is a strictly designed feature which Python originator he has thought it and defined it that way. Jens Gosling of Java, he thought it should be static. Dennis Ritchie at this time, they thought it static. But nowadays, certain other languages like they are going for dynamic, like here, like Python, Ruby, another open source language, they are going for dynamic. There's a weak typing like Perl, PHP, and JavaScript. JavaScript is a very open source language. There's no different relation between JavaScript and Java. JavaScript is basically you're making a front end of most of the application is developed by JavaScript. It is a weak typing. It's a dynamic and weak, but Python is dynamic and strong. We'll come to this. What are these? Yeah, this is the example. Approaches to typing, strongly typed. This is Python is strongly typed, weakly typed. Statically, Python is not statically, Python is dynamically. So C is weak and static. So everything you have to declare at the compile time, and Python is strong and you have to be dynamic time. But remember that whenever the dynamic typing, it is basically suited for glue type of language, so that you can several application runs and vary places, but it can give some exception at the runtime because everything is checking at the runtime. Always there is a comparison between C, whatever you are in a computer science, there is always a comparison between C, Python and Java. So I have told you just now that CF Java is similar in one way, that it is a statically typed, so that you have to declare the variable in the container. You have to declare it whether it is integer or floating point number, you cannot change it. In Java, the one great thing advanced from the C, the integer is the same type. Integer, you don't have like int 8-bit, 16-bit, even small, your mobile computer to a mainframe, Java integer definition is same. C is not. C has some 16-bit version, 32-bit compiler version, 64-bit compiler version. The definition of integer, how many bits will be there, it will change. So your program has to recompile it again and again. Python integer is same format, but Python, one great advantage is you can put as many as big number in integer. So basically, no, integer is very powerful thing. So most of the computer science main problem can be, most of the data types I can solve it in integer, until and unless, because if you go for floating point number, it's more number crunching. So if you have like many the occurrence, like number of students and number of patients in the COVID and all, are basically integer numbers. It cannot be a floating point number. If the floating point number is there, you can assign a floating point. There's an imaginary type of number, like whenever you go for differential equations, solve, then the support is there in Python. So there is a difference between C, Python and Java data type. I have covered it, static typing, because C and Java static type, dynamic typing is Python, Perl. Dynamic typing has some advantage, I told you. Same thing, I'll give the examples here. This is the examples, like X is the, here I put it, X is answer. Now next line I change it, Y is 23. Now if I want to print X plus Y, because it's a, I have using a plus and between integer and string, so it will be Python will create exception, Python will complain, because if it's an integer and floating point number, it will no issue. But if integer and the string or floating point number the string, Python will complain. That is it is though it is a dynamically typed, but it's strong entity. You have to convert it. So here you have to convert, say, with the string operation, str 23, then you can put it. The answer is an str. You have to convert it consciously. Yeah, this is another example I'm giving it. You how to enter a my name, my number. You just give my number, input is a function, enter the number to be diverse. You put my number, then you say I put it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it will consider as that. And then you see, you have to reverse it with this operation, with this list, and this is slicing operation with minus 1. This is not available in C. C, there's a no negative index. C has a positive index. This comes with a 0, 1, but Python has advantage with a negative index. So if you print with negative index, the number will come in reverse. We'll see in our practice. Yeah, this is a, I've covered in my class, this is the, there's a difference between the sequences and collections, or you can say sequences is a set of a, sequences like string, list, tuples, so can an index, and collections is like unordered, like sets and dictionary, all these built-in features in the Python. In some, this picture, sequence is collection is superset, sequence is subset, and this is a not a, this is, so in Python sequences has some function that you can, if you put the length function, it will give how much, what is the length, how many items are there, index, count, and all these things is there. Yeah, these are all are the type of collections. List is mutable, tuple is immutable, dictionary is mutable, set is immutable. So there is some advantages, and all we can always use these features whenever as per our problem criteria. There's another example of frozen set. So if you have a set, it's immutable, there cannot be duplicate items. Whenever you make a frozen set, that is a frozen, that you cannot add and delete, sometimes necessary. It's also immutable. Thank you.